My name is Martin Flowerman.
And everybody likes to hear my story.
They like my memory.
How old was I? I was old enough to know better. I was 27 years old, and I was walking along the Ginza in Tokyo, and it was an unusually hot number of days there. It was not normally that warm. And I hear someone out of the blue say, "Hello." I looked around. Who speaks English here, you know? This little old gray-haired man. He says, "Hello. How are you? You having a good time?" I said, "Yes." I said, "Oh, you speak English very well." He said, "Well," he says, "Oh, it's hot today, isn't it?" I said, "It sure is." I said, "I don't remember it being so hot in Tokyo this time of year." He says, "Oh, yeah, it's very hot." He said, "How would you like a nice cold beer?" I said, "Well, thank you, but I don't really drink beer." But he says, "No," he says, "I have a friend that owns a bar just down the block, round the corner." He says, and a nice cold beer would feel so good now in this heat." I said, "Okay, well, it's very nice of you." I said, "Thank you. I'll go with you." And he takes me up this long, creaky, narrow flight of stairs, and I'm thinking to myself, "Well, I'm safe in Japan. Nobody's going to hurt me. I'm not walking downtown now, Manhattan or something, where I'd never do this." So he takes me up these steps. I get inside. I see this big room with a bar on the left and chairs and couches and tables on the right, and these two pretty well-endowed women standing behind the bar. And next thing I know, he leaves. He goes back down to the street. And I'm alone with these two women. And she said, "Have a little glass of beer for you." I said, "Here, come sit down." And I sit down and I realize, how did I do this? I mean, I'm 27 years old. I wasn't born yesterday. I heard about these things, but I never had this experience before. How did I let that happen? Well, I got to get out of here. And I said, "Tell me, can I pay for this beer? Because I really have to go. Let me pay for this." So she looks at this little cardboard menu type thing with a few items on it. It's in Japanese, and I see the price in yen, 6,500 yen. And I thought, "Whoa, boy, that's $65, something like that." And I thought, "I can't pay that for a beer." I was happy to pay $10-$15 worth, but not $70 for a glass of beer. I thought, no, I'm not giving that to her. And I said, "You know, I don't have enough money for this," but I said, "My friend who's outside, I just need to see him, and I can borrow some money from him, and I can come right back up, and I'll give you the money for the beer." I said, "So if you can wait here, let me go." And I started to lunge towards the door that was locked, and she tried to hold me back. And I managed to unlock the door, and she was trying to hold me back, and I thought, "You can't hold me back. I'm bigger than you are." I was so petrified, I flew down those steps, three steps at a time, and she said, "Be careful, don't get hurt." I thought, "Oh, you sound like a Jewish mother all of a sudden." I just jumped in the first taxi, and I said, "Take me to the Imperial Hotel right away." That's where he took me, and I saw some of my colleagues in the lobby, and I told them what just happened to me. The moral of that story, I guess, don't accept a cold drink from a strange man on the street. Beware. Nobody offers you a free lunch, let alone a free beer. There ain't no free beer.